as Anu already said, I'm Joni Turunen. I'm a senior developer here at Frosmo, and I'm going to talk to you about the multi-armed bandit. First, a little question for all of you. Who knows what is a multi-armed bandit? Just raise your hand. So, about half. Great. That's good. Who knows what is a one-armed bandit? Raise your hand. Should be more. No? Less? At least the gambling guy should know. Yeah. So, the agenda for this presentation is that I'm going to tell you about what is the multi-armed bandit, then comparing it a little bit to the A/B testing, and then telling you about multi-armed bandit in Frosmo, and then some conclusions. So, what is this mob and how does it work? So, the classical problem of multi-armed bandit is that you walk into a room full of slot machines, aka one-armed bandits. And the question you want to know is that which machine should you play in order to make the most profit? So here's a little visualization of that one. You maybe start by playing equally. You play three times each slot machine. Then you see that, okay, the first one gives you the most money. Then you adjust your behavior. So you remember that, okay, the first one gave me more than the other ones. You play it more. But you still want to test the other ones to see if those could be better than the currently best one. So it's about trying out the other ones. So in this case, the second slot machine gives you more. Then you adjust your behavior again and start playing the second slot machine a bit more. But still, always retaining the trying out the other ones also to see if those could be better in the next run. So what this multi-armed bandit is like fundamentally is it's an exploiting and exploration problem. So you exploit the best working arm, but you want to still explore the other ones. And always that probability of the reward guides your decision in making that selection of the arm. So that was about the classical example, in theory how it works. On the web, it's like obviously the arm is one piece of content, and like multiple arms is multiple pieces of content. So this starts to resemble like some kind of A/B testing scenario. Then playing the arm is displaying the content. Then you have to have some kind of measurement how you detect which is the best. So then obvious choices are clicks or conversions, or a combination of those ones. Yeah, so now you know about the basics and fundamentals of multi-armed bandit. So how does this compare to A/B testing? First, a question, like have you ever considered like how A/B testing works with this kind of scenarios? Like you have short-term content, some kind of campaign, one-week campaign, two-week campaign. Maybe you don't have time to run the A/B testing then. You have lots of variations. A/B testing is great for two or three, even four, even five variations. But what if you have 10? What if you have 20? You have to divide it to so big group of people that you can't get the statistical validity there to run the A/B testing and to see which one is the best one. And then low traffic cases or this kind of case that you want to segment users. You have a small group of users and you want to test something for them. So lack of data, or time, or both, might prevent you from running A/B testing. So here's a little comparison between A/B testing and multi-armed bandit. So A/B testing starts with that equal content distribution. So you show each piece of content equally to all the people. And then you can end the test once you have some kind of validity or you know that this particular content is the best, then you can start using it. And usually you do it by manually selecting that one. With multi-armed bandit, once you put it live, it's basically you can start showing the most potential content as early as possible. It is based on probabilities. So the probability of this piece of content getting more reward, so the clicks or conversions, is higher than this one, so we should show that more. And it's also like automatically converging to the best content, so everything is done automatically. You don't have to manually select anything. And here's the visualization, same kind of visualization for that one, that we have four pieces of content here. First one is very low reward, medium reward, and high reward. In traditional A/B testing, you run it for a certain period of time, then you have that manual selection, and you enable the best one. In multi and bandit, how it goes, you put it live, then it starts adjusting. You see that basically maybe it's at the first it's a bit wrong, but it will get you there faster, so that it finds the winning piece of content, so winning arm, so-called. So then a little bit about how does it work in Frosmo. So this feature, we have it there. It's for any modification. You can enable it for any modification, so and you can create as many modifications as you want. So that means you can create as many multi-unbandits as you want in Frosmo. And you select the reward, which is a click or conversion, as we talked about before. And the distribution between the variations start to change immediately. So the one modification is always one bandit, and different variations are the arms for that bandit. Then we have some map algorithms to choose from. So there's tons and tons of algorithms developed for this kind of problem. Well, we have selected five that suits usually this kind of like web development and web content the best. And there are some variations. I will show you a few use cases. So we have the Thompson sampling. It's a very nice, very optimal algorithm. It's our default option. It's based on this Bayesian approach, random beta distribution between different variations, and it's picking it using this Bayesian approach. Then we have the upper confidence family algorithms. We have two of them. It's based on statistical confidence. So they're working a bit differently. They're getting to the same conclusion pretty much, but there's a bit of differences. And then there's softmax, it's kind of Boltzmann distribution, also called as Boltzmann distribution. It's particularly used in like more advanced machine learning cases, like in neural networks. There might be the last layer which decides something. It's often this softmax kind of algorithm there. Then the last one is the most simplest, the epsilon greedy. So you exploit 90% of the time. So you're showing 90% of the time the content that is performing the best. And the last 10%, you're trying out the other arms, so other pieces of content. So now about the use cases. So your use case is that you expect the variation to perform consistently over time. So the click-through rate or conversion rate for that particular content should be quite steady. So then we have the default option, Thompson sampling, or if that for some reason is not working, then you can use the upper confidence bound family algorithms. Then the other case is that you need to show each variation at least to a certain percentage of the users at all times. So you don't want, because this the first two options basically are showing at one time, it's showing only one piece of content there, and then it's checking it, how does it perform, and then it changes it if needed. So this other softmax and epsilon greedy, they always show each content to at least some portion of the users. So that was about the Frosmo multi-unbandit and my talk. So I have some conclusions here. So what multi-unbandit enables you is showing the most potential content as early as possible. It kind of automates your content testing. Of course, it's like fully automated. And it also works in some cases where A/B test just doesn't or can't work. Okay, that's my talk. I thank you, everyone.